Photographic lenses are made of several elements of very pure glass, each element being carefully coated to limit reflection. However, a portion of the light is lost in the optical system due to residual reflection and absorption. When light passes through any medium, such as a lens, some of the light is going to be lost. This light loss is referred to as the rate of transmission. Hang on till the end of this video because I'm going to explain what transmission of light is and how it affects your shooting. Hi, I'm Jim Costa. I'm a full-time working photographer, video producer, video editor, and technology pro. I want to get going on the topic quickly, but do stick around till the end of this video because I'll tell you about some freebies and training courses I offer to improve your photography, video production, and filmmaking work, and to help grow your business through earned media exposure, which is basically through free advertising. If you like what you see, smash that subscribe button and hit that bell to be notified every time I upload a new video each and every Wednesday. Remember, I welcome your comments, questions, and more on all of my videos. With that, let's get started discussing what light transmission is. When you look at something, you're not actually seeing it. You're seeing the light reflected off of that object. If you look at the same object through your camera lens, the light that reaches your sensor is a little bit less than the light you see with your eyes. Light transmission is when light travels through a medium, such as the glass of a lens, without being reflected, absorbed, or scattered. However, in all cases, as light passes through a lens, or any medium for that matter, including even the air, some light loss is going to occur. The transmission factor, or the proportion of light that actually makes its way to the sensor, depends upon the optical formula, which consists of the number of lens elements in a lens, the glass quality and coating, and to a lesser degree on the shooting parameters. So let's look at many of these. Light loss comes from three main sources. Number one is reflections on air to glass optical surfaces. Optical surfaces, which is the outside of the lens, are coated with various materials to reduce reflection losses. Each lens without coatings of any kind reflects approximately 4% on each air to glass surface. And that is for every single element inside the lens. So it's 4% for each one. What that means is that 96% of the light you see with the naked eye reflecting off of an object makes its way to your camera sensor, and 4% of the light is lost. And that's 4% for each element, don't forget. There are ways to mitigate this light loss, however. Lenses can be coated with special chemicals to lessen the effect. Coating effectiveness varies depending upon the type used. For example, a standard single layer coating of magnesium fluoride reduces the loss per surface from 4% down to 1.5%. Multi-layer coatings reduce reflections significantly even more. And for visible light, can reduce the loss per surface to less than 0.1% per surface. However, no coating can reduce the loss to zero. You should always get multi-coated lenses as they will improve the image quality. Number two, scattering of light by defects in the glass, such as internal particles, dust, or scratches. In the manufacturing and processing of a lens, there are always small imperfections such as digs, bubbles, coating, pinholes, and scratches, and other things. In quality glass, the internal imperfections are limited and quite small, but are always present to some degree. Scratches, digs, and coating pinholes are controlled with strict manufacturing tolerances by the companies that make the lenses. Losses from scattering in quality optics are quite small, on the order of less than 0.1%. Ground glass lenses by name brand manufacturers will be better at reducing lens defects than cheaper lenses by knockoff manufacturers, and hence this problem will be lessened. Number three, there is always some light absorption for all glass as the light travels through a lens, as I mentioned earlier. As light travels through glass, some of it is absorbed and converted to heat energy. Absorption in the glass varies depending upon both the glass type and the wavelength of light that is traveling through the glass. Absorption is proportional to the thickness of the glass. Absorption losses are very small for optical glass used in quality optics, and it's somewhere in the ballpark of 2% for an entire multi-lens optical system. So that includes all the elements inside. If an optical system uses a mirror, such as in a satellite, for example, losses often result from the mirror's coating efficiency and scattering from defects that are on the reflecting surface. A high quality mirror surface will reflect 98 to 99% of all light back to the sensor. Your best bet is to go with multi-coated ground glass lenses by name brand manufacturers if you can. These lenses will be better and produce better images and footage with minimal light loss. However, these lenses are not cheap. They can be many times the cost of consumer grade lenses, but the improved quality will make up for the cost, particularly in professional applications. Let's talk a little about transmittance and lens filters. Transmittance is also talked about in relation to the filters that go on to the lens. When used in this context, it is the amount of light that is allowed to pass through the filter and then through the lens, and is usually represented as a percentage, just like with a lens. For example, a filter with a 50% transmittance rate will let 50% of the light through it into the lens and ultimately to the camera sensor. Remember, light loss occurs when light passes through any medium, so that 50% light loss caused by the filter is in addition to the light loss that's caused by the elements within the lens itself. Photographers and videographers are usually concerned about transmittance when they are using neutral density filters. ND filters deliberately cut down the amount of light entering a lens so that a shooter can control the shutter speed, aperture, and ISO beyond otherwise available limits, usually because there's too much light and it's overexposed. For example, using a long exposure to blur moving water is when you might want to consider this. In this case, you want the light entering the lens to be cut down due to the longer exposure time and thus more light getting to the sensor, which would overexpose it. Remember, you'll want to compensate for the light loss by making adjustments to your exposure triangle settings. I've done other videos on the exposure triangle, so you can watch those after watching this video and you can learn even more. I'll link to those videos in the description below. Now, if this is making sense to you, but I've got it in the comments section below. My question of the day is, what's your favorite lens to shoot with and why? Or lens filter for that matter. Leave a comment below and let us know. If you found the information in this video useful, I'd like to hear about it from you. If you liked it and want to see more videos like this, then follow my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films. If you think what you saw was great, please do like it. If you have an opinion, feel free to comment below. If you know someone who could benefit from the information that I provided, please share the video. You can connect with me and my company, Jim Costa Films, on social media and online, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, and the web by searching for Jim Costa Films. In fact, I currently have over 4,600 videos on my YouTube channel, Jim Costa Films, so feel free to check out many of my other videos for great tips and suggestions. Thank you for sticking around this long. I mentioned at the beginning about some freebies and training. As a professional video producer and photographer, I've created an absolutely free cheat sheet for you on all the best camera settings to shoot with your DSLR, mirrorless, or video camera that will show you the settings that will allow your photos, and particularly your videos, to shine and stand out from the competition. The link to get that cheat sheet is just below in the video description. Best of all, my cheat sheet specializes in shooting video with any type of camera. In it, you'll find all the info you need on important video techniques, such as white balance, color temperature, frame rates, and more. I've also created an editing training course for Adobe Premiere Pro. My quick start training is designed to get you up and editing video in under 2 hours and includes over 100 tips, tricks, and keyboard shortcuts for video editors that gets you started in the program and makes your workflow go much faster. Now, I'm also affiliated with Christina Nicholson, a fellow media veteran like myself who helps businesses and entrepreneurs reach tons of their ideal customers or clients through the power of media without spending big bucks on advertising. I've worked with Christina and used her advice and training successfully, so I know from firsthand experience that it works great. The program Christina and I are now offering is called the Media Mentoring Program, and it will help you to take advantage of mainstream media so you can stand out from the competition, because that's not something everyone has access to. Best of all, unlike paid ads and sponsorships, you can gain lots of exposure and credibility to become the go-to brand everyone talks about and wants to do business with without spending a fortune on advertising, because the program is geared to get you free advertising. I'll link to those cheat sheets and training courses in the description below as well. There's videos on both courses that will give you an overview of how they can help you, as well as links to get more information. You can help to support my channel by purchasing my training courses, requesting my free downloads, or by hiring me to shoot and edit for you. Remember, I've also done other videos on filmmaking and video production, and I'll link to those in the description below as well. Finally, if you follow me for a while now, you know that I have a private community of photographers, videographers, and filmmakers just like you on Facebook, where I share other pro tips and tricks. It's called Video Producers and Content Creators. I love new members who want to share their work, learn from others, and also help others based on their own talent, skills, and experiences. The group is private only for people in the filmmaking, video production, and photography industries that I personally work in myself. It's not a public group like my business Facebook page that I talked about earlier. That's public and anyone can see that, because I want them to find me and, you know, hire me to work for them. You'll find a link to that group in the description below, so feel free to join it where you can learn even more.